to this edition of Power Nuggets. Today we look at Christmas as a journey of fulfilled promises. Did you know that Christmas gives you a time, a season of fulfilled promises? There are promises that had been given, prophecies that had been given, and guess what? During Christmas, the prophecies were fulfilled. There are several prophecies that I want to look at to show you that Christmas is a journey of fulfilled promises. God fulfills his promises. The Bible speaks in Isaiah chapter 4 verse 14, "Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel." This prophecy is repeated in Matthew chapter 1 verse 23. When Jesus was born, guess what? The prophecy that had been given 700 years earlier comes to fulfillment. Christmas is a journey of fulfilled promises. Any prophecy that God gave, I want you to understand as we go on, he is willing and is giving you a season to fulfill his promises. It doesn't matter how long the prophecy has stayed, how long the prophecy has delayed, how long the promise has not come to pass. I want you to lift up your faith and understand Christmas is a season of fulfilled promises. Let's look at another prophecy that was given. Micah chapter 5 verse 2 talks about Bethlehem. "But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not least among rulers of Judah, for out of you shall come a ruler who will shepherd my people." During Christmas, the season that Jesus was born, this happened. This came to pass. This came to be fulfilled. In fact, as you continue, we'll see, Bethlehem was not a city that people really liked. Nazareth was not a place that people thought anything good will come out of it. In fact, in John chapter 1 verse 46, Nathanael is asking, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" And this happened because Jesus had to go there. They had to go and live there to wait for the death of Herod. And guess what? At this particular time, as they were there, he became a Nazarene, and it was fulfilled as a prophecy. Anything that God has given unto you, I want you to know he's able to fulfill it. As you continue reading, you will see Herod was not happy with the birth of Jesus, and so he killed every 2 year son and below. And this also fulfilled a prophecy that was given by Jeremiah. Matthew chapter 2 verse 18 refers to that prophecy. He says, "A voice was heard in Ramah, lamentation, weeping, and great mourning. Rachel weeping for her children, refusing to be comforted because they are no more." This prophecy, even though Herod did a heinous act, guess what? It also fulfilled a prophecy that had already been given. Jesus flees, taken to the land of Egypt to avoid the death and the murder that Herod had planned. And as he did that, it was also a fulfillment of a prophecy that was given. "Out of Egypt I called my son." Hosea chapter 11 verse 1 speaks about it. Matthew 2 15 refers to it. "Out of Egypt," while he was running away, guess what? A prophecy was fulfilled. Even the shepherds who went to see Jesus after they saw him, Luke chapter 2 verse 20, the Bible says, "And the shepherd returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen." Why? Because they had been told things, but when they came to see Jesus, whatever they had heard was fulfilled. The promises that were given were fulfilled. Christmas is a journey of fulfilled prophecies. I want to speak to you that God has prophetic words in your life. As we get into this Christmas, understand you're entering into a season of fulfilled promises. Promises that have been made over your life, promises that have been made over your family. God is giving you this possibility, the season of possibilities, fulfilled promises, prophecies that are hovering over you. God is able to fulfill them if you only believe. 1 John 1:1, John speaks and says, "That which we heard, that was from the beginning, that which we heard, and that which we saw, that which we handled, that which we proclaimed to you." What he had, well, that was from the beginning. He came to a level where he was able to handle it and now proclaim to people. This is what is going to happen over this time. It is a journey of you not just hearing, but coming to the level where every prophecy becomes tangible, becomes touchable, manifest in your life. The invisible was able to become visible. Jesus became a human being seen, and he walked on this earth. This Christmas, God is clearly telling us, I am not a man that I should lie. I'm neither a son of man that I should repent. Whatever I have promised you, I am able to fulfill it. This afternoon, I want to encourage someone. This Christmas, open your faith, because it is a season of fulfilled promises. Take the journey to enjoy the fulfilled word of God in your life. See you tomorrow, and God bless you.